Good morning, students. So today we are going to start with the weighted arithmetic mean. बेटे अभी तक जो हमने arithmetic mean किया, that was simple arithmetic mean, in which all the items of the series were given equal weightage. ठीक है? But बच्चे there can be some cases where all the items of the series they are not of equal importance. ठीक है? In that case we make use of weighted mean. Is it clear? So bete weighted arithmetic mean, you can even write it down, refers to the average when different kinds of series, items of the series, when different items of the series are given different weights according to their relative importance. Right? Weighted arithmetic mean refers to the average when different items of the series are given different weights according to their relative importance. So bete weighted arithmetic mean is symbolized by x w bar. How do we calculate weighted arithmetic mean? This is the formula of calculating weighted arithmetic mean. X w bar is equal to summation w x upon summation w, right? So let's start with one question. Given the following data, calculate weighted arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean. So here you are given different values of x, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. You are also given their corresponding weights, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 5. So let's see how to calculate weighted arithmetic mean. Formula I have already written. You also write down the formula. X w bar is equal to summation w x upon summation w. So what we need to calculate is w into x. So that's very simple. It's just like we calculate the arithmetic mean in case of discrete series, where this column is f. In this case, weights w. This column is w. So instead of f, we are doing all the calculations with W. So let's take its total. It is 690 according to me. Also calculate summation W, which is 20. So X W bar summation WX upon summation W, that is 690 upon 20. 34.5. All right. Next, bete. So you are given, I'm reading out one question. You need to write it down. It is a statement. Suppose Savita has obtained 60, 75, 63, 60, and 50 marks in English, accountancy, economics, maths, and business studies, respectively. CBSE has allotted weights to these subjects as 1, 2, 2, 3, 1. Calculate her weighted mean marks. Calculate her weighted mean marks. So you can tabulate your information in this way. First column would be of subjects, second marks, because marks is a variable, we can call it X. Third column, that of W. So in order to calculate weighted mean, we just need to find out W into X. So we'll multiply marks with their corresponding weights. Okay. So it comes out to be, so iska multiply kar lijiye. After that, you are supposed to find out its total. This comes out to be 566 according to me. Now, you also take summation W. 3, 5, 8, and 9. So XW bar is equal to summation WX upon summation W, which is 566 divided by 9. So you find out the answer and give me the answer in the chat box. By the time, I'm waiting for you to complete it. So now we have understood how to calculate arithmetic mean, right, in different types of series. What are the different methods of calculating arithmetic mean, simple arithmetic mean, as well as weighted arithmetic mean. Weighted arithmetic mean is one type of average. There are other types of averages also, median and mode. But arithmetic mean is the most commonly used average. But we have other averages as well. So we have to make a choice. Ki agar hume kisi bhi data ki average find out karni hai, yani data ko ek single value se represent karna hai, to hume kaun sa average use karna chahiye? Shall we make use of arithmetic mean or median or mode, right? So for that, we should evaluate all the measures of central tendency. By evaluating, I mean we should know about the merits as well as demerits of all the averages. So let us first of all discuss the merits of arithmetic mean. But a first merit, it is simple to calculate, easy to understand. Okay? Aapne abhi kara hai arithmetic mean, you must have found it quite simple. So this is the simplest method of finding out average. Secondly, beta, it is based on all the values. Whatever question of arithmetic mean you have done so far, you have taken into consideration all the values of the variable. Okay, in this case, these are the values of the variable. You have taken into account all the values while calculating arithmetic mean. Better you have to write, you don't need to round off the answer, write the exact answer. If you have got the exact answer, write down the exact answer. Okay, so this is another important merit, that no value has been ignored. all the values. This method is this average is based on all the values of the variable, right? Next bit is it is capable of further algebraic treatment. Further हमें कोई भी जैसे measures of dispersion find out करने हैं, ठीक है? तो उस केस में mean use हो सकता है. That is, it is capable of further algebraic treatment, ठीक है? So this again is a merit. Then बेटे it is rigidly defined, its values always definite, right? If I am asking different students to, I have given same series to different students, even if they make use of different methods, they will arrive at same answer. So it is rigidly defined. Next important merit is beta stability. It is a stable measure of central tendency. What does this mean? It means that changes in samples have no effect on arithmetic average or minimum effect on arithmetic average. Now again, what does that mean? Let us suppose your school has 2000 students, right? And we have to find out say average marks of our students. For that purpose हमने कहा सबसे data क्या collect करेंगे? मैंने 10 students को ये task दे दिया कि अपने school के average marks find out करके आओ. तो अब private level पे आपने investigation करनी है, आप student हो, आपके पास इतना time नहीं है कि school के 2000 बच्चों से आप contact करके उनका data collect करके mean निकालो. आपने क्या किया? आपने samples ले लिए. आपने हर क्लास में से लेट से दो दो स्टूडेंट्स ले लिए और उसके बेसिस पर आपने एवरेज मार्क्स फाइंड आउट कर लिया, ठीक है? तो 10 स्टूडेंट्स हैं, तो 10 स्टूडेंट्स ने अपने अपने तरीके से, मैंने कहा आपस में आपने कोई कांटेक्ट नहीं करना है, ठीक है? तो ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हैव टेकन डिफरेंट सैंपल्स, बट वेन दे वुड गिव मी द रिजल्ट, द आंसर ऑफ ऑल दी स्टूडेंट्स वुड बी ऑलमोस्ट सेम. यानी मीन जो है वो सबका सेम ही होगा, यानी कि मीन एक स्टेबल मेजर है सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी का, विच मींस डिफरेंट सैंपल्स लेकर भी मीन की वैल्यू सेम रहती है, ठीक है? विच मींस चेंज इन द सैंपल हैव मिनिमम इफेक्ट ऑन द अर्थमेटिक एवरेज. सो दीज आर द मेरिट्स. बिकॉज ऑफ दीज मेरिट्स बिटे अर्थमेटिक मीन इज यू नो मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज्ड एवरेज. But then it has certain demerits also. But the demerits kya hai? It is affected by the presence of extreme items. ठीक है? Let us say आपकी क्लास के स्टूडेंट्स हैं, उनके मार्क्स जो हैं, they are like 2, 3, 4, 5. एक स्टूडेंट के मार्क्स 90 आ गए. अब इसके करके आपके जो एवरेज है that will be highly affected. This is an extreme item. अगर इसके 90 नहीं आते, मैं आपको सिर्फ ये सीरीज दिखा के आपको बोलती कि इसके एवरेज मार्क्स बताओ कितने हैं, तो आप 5 + 9, 5 + 4, 9 + 5, 14 divided by 4, आप मेरे को क्या कहते? 3.5 एवरेज मार्क्स हैं. And it would have been justified also. Her student के marks 3.5 के around है, ठीक है? लेकिन आपकी class में एक नया student आ गया, उसने जब test दिया तो उसके marks थे 90 out of 100, ठीक है? So now let us see what is the average of your class. It is 9, 12, 14, 104. Now the average becomes 20.8. Now this is not at all representative. No child has average. का मतलब क्या है? Average वो value है जो पूरी series को बेटे represent करती है. यहाँ पे मैंने कह दिया average marks भी मेरी class के 20 हैं और मैम ने आपकी notebooks देख ली. मैम मेरे को कहेंगे आप कह रहे हो average marks 20 है मैम, आपके तो किसी बच्चे के 20 के आसपास marks ही नहीं है, आपने कैसे ये average निकाल दी? I have made no mistake. Yes, arithmetic mean का demerit है बेटे. It is affected by the presence of extreme items. ठीक है, इज इट क्लियर बेटे? देन बेटे इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू डिटरमाइन अर्थमेटिक मीन इन केस ऑफ ओपन एंड सीरीज. आपने ओपन एंड सीरीज किया है ना, बिलो 10, 10 टू 20, 30 एंड अबव, अगर ऐसी सीरीज आ जाएगी तो अर्थमेटिक मीन हम फाइंड आउट नहीं कर सकते. नाउ यू कैन से कि मैम हमने फाइंड आउट तो किया था, तो इन दैट केस बेटे वी मेड अजम्पशंस. ठीक है, हमने अजम्पशंस ली थी रिगार्डिंग लोअर लिमिट एंड अपर लिमिट. राइट, सो दीज आर दी डीमेरिट्स ऑफ अर्थमेटिक मीन. वन मोर डीमेरिट, इट कैनॉट बी डिटरमाइंड ग्राफिकली.